why understanding the Iran conflict over the past decade really is kind of a framework to understand what happened under the Bush administration, what happened under Obama, and what is likely to play out under a Trump administration. On the one hand, you had the United States and its allies, Israel, Saudi Arabia, the Gulf states. And on the other hand, you had Iran and what was kind of, you've heard the early, at least when I first started, heard of the term, the axis of resistance, which was the Iranian regime, its Hezbollah in Lebanon, Hamas in the Palestinian territories, Islamic Jihad, and various Shia militias that were starting to form in Iraq and other countries. So you could really feel towards the end of the Obama administration that, I'm sorry, the Bush administration, that this was a widening conflict, not just between the United States, but two camps, and it was getting increasingly hot. When they say there was a heightened focus on Iran, where I was think there's the potential for conflict or a real standoff is in the Gulf. Over the last year or so, you've seen heightened efforts by Iranian naval vessels to target American or allied ships. You've seen in Yemen a movement there called the Houthis, who are backed by the Iranians, target Saudi, Emirati, and American naval ships. The Americans are supporting the Saudi war in Yemen. So I think there is a risk that tensions in the Gulf could really escalate under a Trump administration.